Ciao und herzlich willkommen bei Es bitz Schwitz, dem Podcast und jetzt auf YouTube. Today is going to be a bit different because I'm going to speak English because the topic of today's video is should I learn High German or Swiss German first? And I'm assuming you haven't started yet with either. I'm also assuming you're like either moving to Switzerland, or you already have moved to Switzerland, or your spouse is Swiss, or like a thousand other reasons, but like you're starting your process of, oh, they speak German. Oh, they speak a different kind of German. What should I do? And that's what we're going to talk about today. German or Swiss German first? Well, the short answer is learn High German first. If that's what you were looking for, learn High German first. Now I'm going to go into why and like why that makes sense, etc. So the longer answer. Before I can clearly answer that question, I need to tell you what is Swiss German? Well, Swiss German is a dialect, much like in English, you have the Queen's English, but then you also have Scottish and Irish and American and Australian and like all those different kinds of English. And it's similar in German. So you have like the High German, which you learn in books and like, you know, that sounds proper. But then you have the German that people speak in Switzerland, in Austria, and then even like within Germany, they have dialects that sound different or slightly different from what you learn in school. In addition to that, Swiss German, there is no one Swiss German. It really depends on where you are. For example, where I come from in Basel, sounds ever so slightly different than people that live in Zurich or people that come from Bern. Or like very different from people who live in Wallis, which is like in the south of Switzerland. They have a very different German. And I have to focus. If I listen to them, I have to focus. The differences aren't always extreme. For example, I tend to say jo for yes, jo. And in Zurich, people tend to say ja, ja. Or a different example would be like, I would say, schöne Ope. Like, have a good evening, schöne Ope. And Zurich people would say, schöne Abig, Abig Ope. You know, so it's like not fundamentally different from each other. It's still German, but it does sound different. And like, there isn't one united Swiss German. Then in addition, it's a spoken language. Like, we don't like, yes, we do write like WhatsApps and SMS, if does anybody still write that, but like, you know what I mean? Like, we tend to write for emails or letters or anything that's official is in High German. And if it's private, sometimes it's in Swiss German, but it's mostly spoken. We learn it by hearing as children. Because it is a spoken language, there is no grammar. Like, well, that's not so much because, but like there is no grammar because we just all speak how we feel it. And with that comes that there is no correct or incorrect spelling either. We just write what we hear. And for example, Xi, which is ich bin Xi, I have been. Xi can be expressed with J-S-I. Or with XI, because it makes the same sound when you say it out loud. So because it's spoken, there is no unified grammar, especially if you go like in the South, Wallis, for example, has a different kind of grammar than the North, like Basel, Luzern and stuff. And there is no correct or incorrect spelling. And there's very little material to learn Swiss German. There is out there and it's getting better. Like Swiss German is picking up and more people are realizing that like people want to learn Swiss German and that we can teach them. Like, but like my podcast or my YouTube or like there's a few others I can help you with that. But there is very little material compared to High German. Oh, and also what I mean by no grammar. Yes, there is grammar. It just isn't correct for all of Switzerland, for all of dialect, for all the dialects. And you, if you have checked out my YouTube channel, you know I made a few videos on grammar and I will continue doing that because it's helping. But it doesn't mean that those are like, not like in High German where you have fixed rules. In Swiss German, it's more like, you know, guidelines. Like if you do it this way, you will be understood. It might be wrong for certain people, but you will be understood. Okay. So now where we know all of that, High German, why High German first? Well, High German has grammar and has correct spelling. Like it gives you so much more you can learn off from than Swiss German. Then there is lots of material for High German. Even if you don't want to spend money, you can, on YouTube, there is so much material. Like check out Easy German, beautiful material. Or German with Anya, also beautiful. I'm not paid, I just really like what they do. But then also like you can, like if you know which grammar structure you want to learn, like Daddy does, you can ask the internet and it will give you material and explanations in English. So you can learn High German better because there is so much material. Also High German gives you a basis, a base. Like it gives you a foundation is the word. It gives you a foundation for, on which you can build on for Swiss German. Like it gives you this basic structure of those are the grammars, the grammatical rules, how they should be. And then let's see what Swiss people do. But like it gives you like this fun, this foundation on which you can build on for Swiss German. And then, as I mentioned, Swiss German is similar to High German. So it's not the same and it is different and it can be hard, all of those things. But at the same time, it's still a dialect of the High German. So like those are kind of like, you know, cousins from each other. And it's like easier to learn like, you know, your brothers and sisters first. That sounds weird. And then get to know your cousins. It's not that far off. It's not a completely different language. And then most Swiss people actually understand High German. So if you know how to speak High German and you're trying your first step in Swiss German, if you're failing and people don't understand what you're trying to say in Swiss German, you still can go back to High German or even English if you want to. But like, as long as you know High German, you can always come back to this and like, get whatever you want to get or communicate whatever you want to communicate. Okay, so that's why you should learn High German first. I hope that was understandable. So now you're asking, so well, what's my plan? How do I do get to learn Swiss German? Well, this is the plan I'm recommending. I recommend that you learn A1 and A2 in High German, and then you can start with Swiss German if you want to. I would recommend that if you have the money or like the budget and the time, if you have the resources, learn B1 High German first and then Swiss German. Because on A1 and A2, you're learning like the basic grammar rules, the basic vocabulary. Everything is new. Everything is scary. You're like getting a grasp on this language. And like, you know, everybody says German is hard. And well, English is too. But German is hard in the beginning. When you start to learn all the vocabulary and like all the grammar rules that are so complicated. And then on B1, I promise you, on B1, stuff starts to make sense. And from there on, it gets better. It gets so much better. And then B1 is like, you know, on B1, you feel kind of comfortable in this language and you start to like, you know, enjoying yourself actually. Where like, you know, just side note, English is quite easy in the beginning, but then let me tell you, I had to learn English as a second language, and like, you know how you guys express your past, I struggle like this whole continuous in the past but not, and like when did it start, when is it ending, and like that has a different, that has an effect on structure. What, that's what it is. So let me tell you, so the plan would be learn A1, learn A2. If you don't have the resources, then go to Swiss German And if you do have the resources, learn B1 on High German and then Swiss German. Of course, you can always, like from the get-go, you can start to learn like your funny Swiss German words you like. For example, you can always use Grüezi, Guten Tag, oder Guten Morgen, Guten Abend, Guten Abend, depending where you are. Ade, Adje, Messi, Merci, and Gute for good appetite, like enjoy. We say Gute, it's very important to Swiss people. of course, you can like from A1 on, you can start to use those words to like show that you're trying and like to get more comfortable with Swiss German. But I wouldn't recommend doing this too much. Like I wouldn't learn at the same time, mostly because it's easy to get confused, especially on like A1, A2. Like the numbers, they're ever so slightly different in Swiss German. And then you're still learning them in High German. So don't, I personally wouldn't recommend to do it at the same time. Okay. Now, no surprise, you can learn with me. You can learn High and Swiss German with me. I've wrote a book. Actually, I'm writing the second one, and it's called Autodidakt A1, and I'm working on Autodidakt A2. If you don't know what Autodidakt means, it means like someone who learns by themselves. So there is an Autodidakt program. As I said, I wrote a book that is designed for you to learn in your own pace on by yourself online. Okay, so like, okay, wait, I explain to you. So the structure is that you have planned 3 lessons per week. In the first lesson, you learn a new structure or new vocabulary or new ways to express yourself. In the second lesson, you do exercises. I give you exercises which correct themselves so you can like train what you've learned. And then in the third lesson, we are actually either meeting one-on-one, and I'm also working towards group lessons, so it's cheaper. So yeah, we meet in the third lesson, we meet one-on-one, and we speak about what you've learned. That there was interview questions, and like you can ask questions about the grammar you didn't understand, etc. Then I will correct your homework on Fridays and Saturdays. So you do your homework, and because it's online, it's a Google document, you can allow me to see your Google document, and then I can go in and correct and leave comments on your homework and what you've done in lesson one to make sure you're not learning something that is wrong. And then you also get reminders on Slack. Like I have groups, and I think it's also called channels. But I will remind you on Slack, like, hey, have you done lesson 1 and 2 already? Where are you work? Are you still working, etc., to like hold you accountable. And then if you follow the structure, if you do 1 lesson per week, like those 3 lessons, but one lección, one chapter, let's call it a chapter, 1 chapter per week, you will be done from 0 to A1 in 7 months, in a little bit more than half a year, you can be done with A1. And then my goal is to that you also in another 6 to 7 months, you can also learn A2 in the same structure. That means that like within a year, you can start learning Swiss German. Depends on how fast you get to work. But yes, that's like my guarantee if you follow that structure. If you're wondering what that might cost, well, it's not for free. It usually costs like the normal price for all of this, the book, those two lessons where you work by yourselves, plus meeting me once a week costs normally the value of that is 175 Swiss francs. That's actually not true. That's not the value. The value is much higher, but the normal price is 175 Swiss francs per month. But I have a winter Christmas kind of special price going on, and it will be 119 Swiss francs per month. So if you are interested in working with me, either you can book an assessment lesson on Calendly. I will also leave the link in the description, or you can DM me on the Facebook group for Espit Suites. Or you can also just like leave me a comment in the comment section here and I will react to it. Okay. Wonderful. So high German first, then Swiss German to answer your question. Well, that's all for today. I hope you learned something and see you soon. Bye. Tschüss. Ciao. Ciao.